This video is based on MantaRay's optimization algorithm. As you can see here, everything related to this algorithm is discussed in Path Burn. You can check the link here or in the description box. In this video, we will try to understand how this algorithm is working step by step with numerical example. Or if you are trying to solve this algorithm using numerical example, then you can follow certain steps. First step is parameter initialization. Here we will initialize all the important parameters, for example, population size, maximum of iteration, lower bound, upper bound. Here you can see population size is 3, maximum of iteration 5, and you can see lower bound, upper bound. Now initialize the population randomly. Here you can see for the 3 search agents, we initialize the population randomly, and here all the values are within the bound. You can check the lower bound and upper bound. You can see all the values are within bound. Now using a fitness function, or you can say cost function, we will calculate the fitness value for the each agent in the current population. I'm using here a sphere function. Put all the values here, put all the values in this function, and we got initial fitness values, this one. Now find out the best solution among all. Here best solution means solution having minimum value, that is this one, and the worst solution means solution having maximum value. Now the main loop for this algorithm start here. This is the stopping criteria. Until the stopping criteria is satisfied, we will repeat this loop, and when this stopping criteria is satisfied, we will display the best solution that you got in the previous iteration. Here you can see this is the for loop for 1-2 population size, and we are going to repeat this loop until this condition is satisfied. Now let's try to understand how this is working. So first you can see current iteration is 1-5. 5 is here maximum of iteration. So until this condition is satisfied, we will repeat this loop. Here you can see this is for loop. Now if this condition is true, here random value is a normally distributed random value within 0 and 1. So select any random value that is normally distributed random value. If this condition is true, then perform cyclone parsing, else chain parsing. Here this is the mathematical model for the cyclone parsing, and this is the mathematical model for the chain parsing. For example, I have a random value, suppose this one, and right now this condition is false, so we will perform chain parsing. How we can perform chain parsing using this mathematical model? First we will calculate the value for alpha. After that, we will update the value for the first search agent using this equation. As you can see, we updated the value for the first search agent. Now, how we can update the value for the rest using this equation? As you can see, I is 2 to n. Now, again, we will select any random value and check this condition. If this condition is true, then perform this one, else this one. So again, here you can see I is 2-3, that is 2-2 population size. If this condition is true, then perform this one, else chain forcing, that is this one. After that, you will got updated values for the each search agent. Now we will check whether all the updated solutions are within the boundary or not. Here boundary means we need all the values within bound, lower bound and upper bound. So check all the solutions whether they are within the bound or not. After that, calculate the fitness value for the each individual and select the best among all. And after that, we will perform somersault forcing using this mathematical model for each. Here you can see I is 1-n, that is 1-3. So use a for loop here where for I is 1-3 and update the position for the each search agent using this equation. And after that, check the boundary whether all the solutions are within the bound or not. After that, again calculate the fitness value for each individual and select the best solution among all. And we will repeat this loop until the stopping criteria is met. Once the stopping criteria is satisfied, return the best solution that you got in the previous iteration and display the best solution, its fitness value and position. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.